Good morning, dear students. Today I am present with the poetry section. And the first poem composed by Robert Frost, a great American poet, is going to be discussed here. By the way, the first poem is a very short one. There are two poems prescribed in your course by Robert Lee Frost. The first poem is Dust of Snow. Before we go to understand the poem, which is a very short poem, having a few lines only, I think 5 to 6 lines only, we need to understand who Robert Frost himself was. The full name of Robert Frost was Robert Lee Frost. He was an American poet born in San Francisco and died in Massachusetts of America. Robert Lee Frost was popular all over the world as a poet for rural depiction. In his poems, we find almost the description of rural scenes, natural scenes, the scenes regarding countryside fields, countryside trees, rivers, beautiful jungles, beautiful and dense forests, snowfall, etc. You can well understand who Robert Frost was by the famous lines composed by him. The woods are lovely, dark and deep, but I have promises to keep and miles to go before I sleep and miles to go before I sleep. These four lines composed by Robert Frost became popular all over the world. And the first Prime Minister of our country, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, was very much fond of these four lines composed by Robert Frost. And he had written these four lines inside his room in order to give himself some kind of inspiration. So this was Robert Frost, whom we come to understand today. This was a short description about Robert Frost. He was a teacher, he was a farmer, he was a writer, he was a poet. He was settled in America, but as a poet, he got settled in England, and his first poem was published from England. First he became popular in England, later on he became popular in America. What is dust of snow? Dust of snow stands for a particle of snow. So whenever snowfall happens in hill areas, in cold regions, so there are some particles of snow which are left upon the plants, which are left upon the terrace, which are left upon any other thing. Okay. One day, the poet was very much sad. He was in depression. He was quite hopeless. And he was sitting under a tree which is mentioned here as hemlock tree. H-E-M-L-O-C-K. Hemlock tree. Hemlock tree is a poisonous tree. It's a tree whose leaves are poisonous and which is also used for intoxication like drink, tobacco, etc. So the poet was sitting in a mood of depression. He was very much sad. He was sitting under a hemlock tree and there comes a crow. This crow was sitting upon one of the branches of the hemlock tree. And from the branches of the hemlock tree, suddenly falls a particle of snow upon the poet. The poet who was in pensive mood, the poet who was in depression, the poet who was in sad mood, as the particle of snow fell upon him, his mood suddenly changed. He became happy. Why did he become happy? He became happy because a crow changed his mood. So that thing has been described here by the poet. Now we should come to understand the text. Dust of snow, the way a crow shook down on me, the dust of snow from a hemlock tree has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day I had ruled. Now you see, the way a crow shook down on me, the dust of snow. The poet tells us here, one day he was sitting in a mood of depression. He was very much sad and disappointed. He was thinking on the negative part of his life. And he was sitting under a hemlock tree. What happened there? The poet's sad mood was surprisingly changed by the interference of a crow. What happened there? There came a crow. This crow was sitting upon one of the branches of hemlock tree. And from there, the snowfall, the remains of snowfall, the remains of snow which were there upon the branches of the tree, the crow moved some particle of snow which fell upon the poet. And when this particle of snow fell upon the poet, his mood was suddenly changed. Because a person, when he is lost in disappointing things, when a person is in the mood of depression, when he is lost in something negative, thinking, and anybody comes and interferes, suddenly the mood of that person changes. Here, any human being did not come to change the mood of the poet. There came just a crow. This crow moved, shook the branch of the tree, and from the branch of the hemlock tree, some particle of snow fell upon the poet. From a hemlock tree has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day I had rued. R-U-E-D, rued. Rued means the poet had felt disappointingly. Rude stands for the sad feelings of the poet. The entire day was a day of depression for the poet. The complete day was a day of hopelessness and a disappointment for the poet. He was sitting under the hemlock tree thinking over the negative part of his life when he was disappointed, and suddenly a crow came there. It shook the branch of that tree, and from the branch of that tree a particle of snow fell upon him, which gave the poet a kind of pleasure, which gave a poet a kind of change of mood. In this way, the poet's mood changed there. Now, dear students, try to understand. Crow is the symbol of negativity. Hemlock. Hemlock is also the symbol of negativity and depression. And these negative points came to be totally changed by a positive point, which is snow. So the poem is also symbolic. Crow and hemlock stands for negative things. Snow stands for positive thing. Now, you come to understand the rhyming scheme of the poem. Crow matches to snow, me matches to tree, heart matches to part, and mood matches to root. You will call crow first line A, me does not match to crow, second line it will be called B, snow matches to first line, that's why it will again be A, A, B, A, B. Tree matches to second, that's why it will be A, B, A, B, A, B, again, C, D, C, D. So A, B, A, B, C, D, C, D is the rhyming scheme of this poem. You can note it in your copy. A, B, A, B, C, D, C, D is the rhyming scheme of this poem. I think you got it to understand. In order to better understand, watch my video repeatedly. Thank you very much.